Hello, friends, and welcome back to my channel. I am so excited today because a lot of you are here because you found me through Notion videos. Whether it's my recurring tasks video, my day in the life of Notion video, a lot of you found me through my Notion videos. And today I'm super excited because the Notion Digital Planner got an upgrade this month and it is going on Black Friday sale later this week. So I wanted to walk you through what are some of the things that have been added, what are some of the changes that have been made so that you can really enjoy the beauty of having a personal, perfect Notion second brain for yourself that really helps you wrangle all of the chaos, not just in your personal life, but potentially in your corporate career, your business, or your life as an educator, because there are built-in templates for all three of those things inside of the Notion Digital Planner. Let's take a look. Like I said, the Notion Digital Planner got an upgrade this month and this fall, and I'm really, really excited to share it with you as a means for you to really take back and organize your life. It's gonna be a game changer. So as you can see on this first page here, we have this 40-minute walkthrough video, which is gonna show you how to use this system. So it's all gonna be super clear. Now, one thing I do wanna point out that sometimes I forget to say is that this planner is outside of the block limit for the free Notion plan. Notion instituted a 1,000 block limit, and this planner does exceed it. So if you wanna stay with the free plan, this probably isn't the planner for you, but Notion is literally only like $48 for a year. So I do definitely recommend upgrading. Now, what I wanna go ahead and show you is some of the updates that I made to some of the various different spreads inside of this planner so that you can see some of the ways in which it's been improved. So one of the things I did do is I kind of made it a little bit more minimalist, kind of trying to mimic my setup. And then I also brought back the old main dashboard setup. I got a lot of feedback from various different people that they really liked this main dashboard setup. So I brought this back and I even brought it back in my systems as well. I'll admit I don't use this particular setup a ton anymore, but this is a system that a lot of people recommended and asked that I bring back. And one cool thing that it does have is it's got some synced blocks on this page. So this word of the year block is actually synced between this page and the OKR goals page. It's also got a my purpose block that is synced as well. But I show you all of my different widgets. And one of the things I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be upgrading the videos inside of that course that I mentioned at the beginning to show you how to kind of personalize and add all of these different things. Now, the My Day view is very, very similar to how it was before. This is a very, very basic view, but sometimes this is better for some people, but this really hasn't changed too much. I have really found that I don't use either the main dashboard or the My Day view very much. I actually personally use my Productivity Hub, which I'm going to show you in just a second. You do have a Productivity Hub. We're just not quite there yet. So I also want to show you that I reintegrated the check-in and check-out pages. So one of the videos that I've actually got on YouTube, which is quite popular, is my check-in and my check-out, my like Notion daily routines. And so what I've gone and done in here is I have set up these check-in and check-out pages exactly how you will see my check-in and check-out pages are. These are my current systems. I'm currently changing some things about my system. So if this is something you're interested in hearing more about, like my updated check-in and check-out, definitely drop a comment below. I'd be happy to touch on these check-in and check-out processes again. So those are some of the dashboards. Now we're going to go ahead and move to the Productivity Hub. The Productivity Hub is what I used to call the task manager. And I personally, as I mentioned before, work out of the Productivity Hub primarily in my Notion dashboard. So this is a look at mine. And one of the things I'm going to be putting in those upgraded videos for the course that's going to show you how to use this planner is some of the personalizations I've done, like adding in the Google Calendar widget. I'm adding in the purpose block and the quotes at the top. So I'm going to show you how to do those things if you want to. That's really the only differences between mine and this particular page is that I've added in some of those customizations. That's on the docket for me in December to upgrade that course, so it'll definitely be coming soon. There is also a project hub where you can see all of the different projects that are currently active. I don't use this view a whole heck of a lot, but there's also a quick capture page, and this is exactly the same because I love my quick capture page. I really feel no need to update it. It just works so well as it is, this very simple setup. So if this is something you need in your system, honestly, it's one of my favorite parts of my particular system. Now let's take a look at the OKR goals page. This is probably the page that got the biggest refresh. And one of the big things I did here is I simplified it. So instead of having to manually choose the quarter or the month that each goal or objective goes with, I automated it. I also pulled in the quarters from the quarterly review page so that you can use the quarterly review to more inform your goal setting. And that's a little bit more integrated than it used to be in the previous version of this planner. Now, in terms of the objectives, I want to show you what I changed because I think it's a little hard to appreciate because basically I made it so that it is automated when it pulls in the quarter instead of you needing to, as I said,
manually pull in the quarter from this other database. This other database is still here, but it automates the entire process so that you don't have to use the relation property. Instead, what you can go ahead and do is click into your goal, expand the properties, and then go in and select the target deadline for your goal. So let's say this is November 30th. You can see that it automatically went in and it designated the month as 11, the quarter as Q4, and it designated it as this quarter and this year. So all of that happened automatically just by adding in some properties instead of having to rely on the relation property where you have to manually go in and select the quarter or the month. I hope that makes sense, but the idea here is it is automated now instead of you having to do it by hand. And one of the cool things is now we can filter by those properties as well. So not only does it automatically identify what the month and the quarter is for that particular goal, but now we can automatically filter our objective views and our current and project views by those things without us having to do any extra work. And like, honestly, how cool is that, right? So on this main objective view, for example, not only is it showing you all of the projects that are in progress, but it's showing you all of the projects that are in progress just for this year. You could also filter by this quarter, and you can see that I have an objectives by quarter view as well. So it's really, really meant to make it very seamless and very integrated so that you don't have to do so much work manually. This was a change that I made in my planner, and I knew I had to make it in the digital planner as well, just to make it so, so much easier for you. The next thing I went and did is I added in a knowledge and learning hub. This is the exact same knowledge and learning hub that's inside of my system, and I have been loving using this to capture notes and projects that I've been working toward and online courses, as well as some other things that I've captured. The travel planner is exactly the same. This is something I use for personal and professional travel. The vision board is also very similar. I prefer vision boarding inside of Notion than vision boarding elsewhere. And then the reviews and reflections are the same, but they've been updated. So I went in and I added in my most current reviews and reflections processes so that you can have those in there. So you can see I've got my goal reflection at the top and then my how am I feeling and then the basic reflection at the bottom. So that's my current weekly review. I also have in here my current monthly review, which these change frequently. So I'm not going to go in and change them all the time, but this is the one that's been working really well for me for the month. You can also see the current review for the quarter, which doesn't look super different than the last time I updated it. And then you can also see the current review that I use for the year. I don't know why I keep clicking into the top corner because that's not where we need to go to see it. But this is the current yearly review as well. So all of those reviews and reflections templates are also updated. Now, the databases and all these other areas are basically organized exactly the same, but what I do want to show you is I want to show you some of the different health hubs and finance hubs that I went ahead and updated that have a whole bunch of new stuff in them. So we've got our life handbook. The journal is something that I added in as well. That is actually something that is a little different than it used to be, but we've also got the finance hub. So this is very similar to what it used to be, but it's just named slightly differently. We also have the home hub, and there's a lot of stuff in this that is brand new. So in the home hub, I added in some cool logs that can just help keep track of things like the vehicle maintenance log, the medical visits log. You might also have a pet, so maybe you need to keep track of your vet visits inside of there. And then there's also inventory, rooms to clean, and cleaning tasks just to help you better organize the different tasks that you might need to just keep your home environment, you know, nice and clean. There's also an inventory where you can keep track of the things that you might need to buy. And then I also have a people and contacts database. I personally use this. I showed this to you in the last video for keeping track of personal addresses and who I'm going to be sending like Christmas cards to, but I also use it for professional connections as well as like thought leaders and authors whose content I consume. There's also a meal planning page in here, which is also linked to the health hub to help keep track of recipes. So the home hub got a serious upgrade. Now there is also the journal, as I mentioned a second ago. The journal is exactly the same setup that I use for my journal. I'm going to be going in and adding in some templates that I use when I'm journaling as well so that you can have those systems inside of your digital planner as well. So that's something I'll be adding very, very soon. Not quite done yet as I record this. And then there's also the health hub. The health hub also got some new stuff added to it. So there is still the recipes in the journal. There is a sleep tracker where you can go in and track your sleep. There's also the meal planner, as I showed you just a second ago. There's a fitness tracker where you can keep track of your workouts and your rest, your calorie counter, and your food diary. So those are all good ways to help you stay on top of your health. There's a supplement tracker if you need to track how frequently you're taking your supplements, a physical symptoms tracker, a mood tracker, and then as I showed you in the previous view, there's also a medical visits tracker. So all of those are inside of the health hub to better help you keep track of your health. And then I added in a page that I was inspired to add by Jules Acree. I follow her, as I'm sure many of you do. And I really liked this as a way to design my morning routines, my evening routines, as well as just to give me some ideas for how we can design those days. And then you can see all of the different databases down below for like the fitness and the sleep tracker, et cetera. Those are all accessible there as well. The last things in here I want to show you are the different dashboards. So the corporate dashboard and the educator dashboard are basically exactly the same. I actually did a video for the educator dashboard not too long ago. So if you're a teacher and need something like this, that is there for you, and it's built into the system and it's all integrated with the other things like the task manager. So all your tasks appear in one place. But the biggest place that got an upgrade was the biz owner dashboard. I added a lot of new views to the business owner dashboard. I basically set this one up so that it exactly mirrors the layout of my business dashboard. So you can see that right here. Like the layout is basically exactly the same in my dashboard as it is in the dashboard inside of the Notion Digital Planner. But I want to show you some of the things that I added. So the Vivid Vision is new, the Ideal Week is new, and basically how I use the Ideal Week is I use it to kind of map out, as it sounds, ideally how I want to spend my time during the week. So I have my Ideal Week in here that you can use as inspiration. There's also the Vision, Mission, and Values. There's the Offer Suite Breakdown. There's the Biz Stats Tracker, the Testimonials, and then some of the new pages are like the Core Tools and Teachings, the client portals, and the client resource library. Now, the core tools and teaching is an empty database, but let me actually go ahead and show you my core tools and teaching so you can see a little bit about how I use this. I use it to keep track of some of the things that are core tools in my business and in my coaching methodologies, and whether or not they're ones that I'm researching or testing, or they're ones that I've newly learned. Now, the other thing that I have in here is my client CRM and my client resource library. Let me show you the client resource library because this is also something I added to the Notion Digital Planner. And this is how I use mine. I basically use it to keep track of all of the different resources I might share or give my clients access to. And you can see I have them organized not only by resource and where I got them from, but also by tag. So you can see they're classified by like anxiety and stress, and then all of my resources. And this actually connects to my client portal so my clients can have access to these. So let me actually show you what the client portals look like, because the client portals are a really cool new feature that I added inside of here that I wanted to give you access to because it's an aspect of my systems that works so stinking well. So if we go in here and check out the client portal, you can see it's a whole layout for a new client. So we have all of the information they need to not only onboard, but do their coaching program and their offboarding. So here we've got underneath the onboarding page, we've got our Start Here page where we can go in and we can customize the information for their program to get started. We've got the contract page, which you can customize as well. The intake questionnaire, which I copied over from mine and I recreated from my intake questionnaire. We've also got for the actual coaching and the program, we've got the course. If you have a course that you're running your clients through, we've got their actual coaching program. So where you can take notes and schedule calls. We've got course progress. We've got the resources, which this actually links to the client resource library I shared before. So it's all nice and synchronized. And then for the offboarding, we've got a recap page where you can recap their coaching program, any like big takeaways that you know that they need to, you know, have on hand, where they can reflect on their program as well, a place for them to give feedback on their experience, and a place for next steps so that you can continue working with them if that's something you'd like. So all of this is built into the coaching portal, but what I want to show you is something super cool about the coaching portal. I actually set up the Notion Digital Planner to do exactly what my planner does when I onboard a new prospect. So if I click into that new prospective client inside of my client CRM, there's a button at the top that says onboard new client. We're going to click on it. And when we click on it, what it's going to do is it's going to prompt us to ask, are you sure you want to take the client on? Which is always a good double check to do. And then once you click continue, it is going to populate a whole bunch of tasks down at the bottom here, which we're going to take a look at in just a second. And then it's going to say, would you like to go to the client's portal? Now you can change this if you want to, but I usually go to the client portal immediately after onboarding a client so that I can start to customize the content in the portal. And what I love about this is it seamlessly takes you right to that client portal so that you can start to do the customization. But simultaneously in that same step, you can see that it not only syncs the client portal to the client, it also added in all sorts of action items that we need to do to onboard that client. This is one of the things that I do to really, really make my onboarding process seamless. And you can actually see that those tasks that got added to the client, if we go back over to our productivity hub, they got added into the productivity hub as well. And that, once again, is the beauty of this system. It's seamless, it's integrated, and it's all in one place.
That is it. That is the end of my walkthrough of the updated Notion Digital Planner. Honestly, the level of automation and taking advantage of some of the new Notion features that have been added to this baby, I am so excited about. I did them to my own planner, and honestly, it just kind of felt like I was letting you down if I didn't do them to the Notion Digital Planner as well. So no longer do we have to know, you know, manually select the quarter or the month that a goal is associated with in the OKR goal setting system. No longer do I have to go back into my client and actually click on their client portal when I onboard them. It all happens with those clicks of the button. And I love that about Notion. So I hope you're as pumped for the changes as I am. If you've got any questions or comments or curiosities, drop them in the comments below. Once again, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget, this guy's going on Black Friday sale this week. So if you are interested in getting your hands on this for a super discounted price, as well as getting that walkthrough course, which I will admit is not updated as I record this, but will be updated in December to walk you through exactly how to use the course, that's gonna be available to you as well when you purchase your Notion Digital Planner. So I hope you're as excited as I am. Thank you so much for being here, my friend. Thank you so much for watching, and I will talk to you next time. Bye.